And I remember thinking, I never offered my silence. My silence was assumed because silence is necessary for the larger architecture to continue.
My name is Cristina Cala, and I'm the founder of the Why Women Project. We're very privileged to have Reema Zaman with us here today. We're going to talk about her memoir, which is her debut, I Am Yours. Welcome, Reema.
It's all about silence culture, and I believe the world has suffered so long from silencing certain voices, the voices of immigrants, the voices of women, the voices of any kind of marginalized person. And that's why you have your company, that's why you have this beautiful book club, and it's why I wrote this book.
We really believe that it's important to allow women and non-binary people and people of all different origins who haven't had the privilege of telling their own stories to take that power back and tell it.
I had never seen a memoir written by a Bangladeshi woman that spoke on the things I wish I had been given entry into as a young reader. And so for a long time I felt I was invisible because media didn't portray anyone like me. I wrote this as a love letter to anyone who has been through similar traumas as I have, sexual assault, intimate partner violence, self-harm, and an invitation, a call to empathy for the men in our lives. Because to evolve as a human family, we will need everyone's participation.
How the culture of silence and the culture of abuse are linked together.
We live in a culture that has normalized toxic behavior for so long. Silence culture thrives on us being obediently quiet, right? And if we continue to rationalize and forgive things that are actually just violence, we then feed into silence culture. We become complicit.
Early chapters where you talk about your childhood, you describe yourself as American in personality.
Right.
You're very outspoken.
Outspoken.
And that was something that you made people in your life maybe a little nervous.
And I think we get told that in so many cultures as women, that yes, you're wonderful as you are, but maybe tone things down a bit. The key is to stop apologizing for the space we take up, to stop apologizing for the volume and audacity of our voice. And that's the ending we have, where I'm able to say to myself, I am yours. I am my own.